Hi folks, Will from MinIO here, and in this second part of our video series on events, I'm going to be discussing event destinations and event notifications and how those work together to actually publish events from the MinIO server. So we've seen all the events that we can trigger. Where do these events go? MinIO itself is not really set up to have sort of this exposed events handling, but you can send these events out to a destination. We have three types of destination available for MinIO: database destinations, queue destinations for message queuing, and also webhooks. And webhooks are where you get into your custom code. You can set a webhook up to do whatever you want. Database, this is where you maybe want to store some tracking, some auditing information, and of course with a queue, you would send stuff to the queue. It would persist that event until it's read and handled by, again, probably another webhook on the end. So MinIO supports three different databases out of the box. You can send your events to Postgres, MySQL, or Elasticsearch. Elasticsearch is a great option if I want to do some further reporting, because Elasticsearch, the platform, has lots of reporting abilities built into it with its Kibana tools and things like that. But Postgres, MySQL, Elasticsearch, these are great places to send stuff if you want to keep sort of an audit log, an audit trail of every event that's happened in your system. With queues, this is going to allow you to persist this message until it's handled. This is a really great way to make sure that no events are actually lost. If you want to send an event to a queue of some kind, we have these already built in: Kafka, MQTT, AMQP. You can send it to Redis, you can send it to NATS, you can send it to NSQ. All of those are built in. It's easy to stand up. You just click the button, stand it up in whichever way you want. The webhook event destination is what you're going to use if your preferred service that you want to send your stuff to isn't directly available. You can write a webhook, or you can deploy a webhook as an excellent option if your system has a webhook available. For instance, Slack in many cases has these webhooks. You can set up a Slack webhook for this and then connect into that webhook. You can also write your own custom code to handle events with a dedicated service. Now, here's the important part. All of your webhooks that you're going to stand up, they need to be able to connect to a simple queue service. MinIO implements a simple queue service to actually send the events out. And so what we're going to be doing is we're going to be reading from that simple queue service. With that, you can do basically anything that you want. Keep in mind that all of these events are going to be handed out as JSON objects, which you can then parse with any tool that can manage JSON. This is one of the reasons why Elasticsearch and all the databases are really handy, because you have the ability to parse that JSON into whatever format you want. It's really great. So an event destination, whether it's a webhook or a database or a queue, these are cluster wide. So you're going to set up your event destination once, and then you can reuse that for many different event notifications from various buckets. Before we go on, let me show you how we can register an event destination. So here on my service, I have a server running. I have this MC admin info MinIO 1. Let me show you what we've got. It's a very simple service. It is one drive. It is one node. There's nothing really major going on here. But if I want to register an event destination, I can do that very simply. All I need to do is MC admin. And I do a config set. MinIO 1 is my alias. And then I need to tell it what kind of service I'm connecting to. In this case, I'm going to connect to a notify web service, or rather notify webhook service. And this is, anytime I'm doing a webhook, this is what I would use to connect to it. And then I need to give this minimally an endpoint. And it's also handy to give it a queue limit. So here's my endpoint and queue limit. My endpoint is Flask, and that's here on my learn.minio service. It is running on port 443 because it is HTTPS. And then I also have this queue limit of 0. So this is a very basic web hook that I have got running. So when I run this, it says successfully applied new settings. Please restart your server. We'll go ahead and do that. MC admin service, restart MinIO 1. And because this is a site-wide service, this is why I have to restart this. I have to restart this because the entire server needs to know about it. So we have now successfully restarted MinIO, and I have registered my service. My webhook is running right here in this other tab. Here it is. It's a very simple Flask deployment. it's not doing anything. Well, the reason why it's not doing anything is because even though I have the service registered as a destination, I haven't subscribed to any events yet. So we need to do that. That's the next thing we need to do. So now let's go ahead and talk about some event notifications. Notifications are basically per bucket notifications. This is how you're going to set up most of the event listing that you're going to do. Generally speaking, you're not going to do the site-wide ones as event notifications. You're going to work with that a little bit differently. But MinIO allows your event destination to be subscribed to a bucket that is going to publish events to a simple queue service. That simple queue service is then going to be read by our destination whenever there is an event sent to it. So the way that you set this up is you need to get the ARN, the Amazon resource name, for the simple queue service. Now, for instance, you would see something like ARN, MinIO, SQS, and then you would have the name and the type. The destination that I just set up as notify webhook service, that appears here as service colon webhook. So what you would see is the name of the service, whatever you named it, and then the type, webhook, database, queue, okay? The name and the type are gonna vary by the destination. You will see all of this information. You can see all this information in your console and work with it that way. You can limit the event types if you want. There are the put, the get, the delete. You also have replica, ILM, and scanner types. And that's gonna be the put star, that's gonna be the create star, it's gonna be the access star, it's gonna be the remove star, it's gonna be replica star, ILM star. And then you put in optionally the prefix in the bucket that you want to watch, or the suffix, right? If there's only certain types of objects, certain object suffixes that you want to watch for, that's where you would set this up. So there's that MC event add. This is on a bucket on MinIO one called bucket. And I'm just using that webhook that I just did. I'm gonna look for events that have a prefix of new and a suffix of JSON. So once I've done that and I start uploading objects to that bucket that have a .json suffix on them and are in the new prefix, I will start seeing events. So as a little difference from the per bucket notification, we do have these two system-wide notifications. Bucket notifications and scanner notifications can both be watched across the entire service. So I can do that using a watch. Now this is not going to use an event notification. It's not going to use an event destination. It's literally going to work in your terminal. So if I do an MC watch dash dash event scanner across MinIO one, this is going to watch for scanner events across my entire server. Now, the reason why I might want to do this is because every once in a while, you know, if my system is running slow or something like that, maybe I want to do a quick check and say, do I have any buckets out there with 1,000 versions of an object or 50,000 prefixes? Then I would just run this event scanner very briefly to say, oh yeah, I've got a few. I don't necessarily want to have it running constantly on a bucket, and every time that thousand version object pops up, it's gonna send me another event. I wanna watch the event and I wanna handle it pretty quickly. So this would be something I would do live. Similarly, that bucket notification, MC mirror uses our bucket notification so I can watch the replication of the bucket from MinIO 1 to MinIO 2. It's a good way for me to keep track of everything being mirrored in that way. Thanks for joining us on this discussion of events. In the next video, we'll be taking a look at how you can do a custom webhook with Python. I hope you've enjoyed this one, though. If you have and you'd like to reach out with us, you can use any of the methods you see here on the screen. You can also chat with us interactively on slack.min.io or just leave a comment here on the video. Thanks, and we'll see you for the Python video.